population and controlling the people.
You had a ship full of African men, women, and children who were at the mercy of the captain and all the sailors on that crew. And those men could have sex with anybody they wanted to. The women, the children, and the men.
You had to see 3 months tied down with these white men. There ain't no women there for the most part. When they start bringing women, they weren't even bringing women. They were bringing girls between the ages of 6 and 15 and raping them all. But they also were raping the men. Same things are happening on the plantation to demasculinize the black man.
Control the slave population is to rape a father in front of his sons, or to take the biggest, baddest black man on the plantation and do something horrible to him to completely humiliate and emasculate him so that people won't respect him anymore. And that still happens to this day.
In the Caribbean, they had seasoning plantations, which were plantations used to break the slaves. And one plantation or one place that had a lot of seasoning plantations was Jamaica. And people have to wonder, what were they doing on these seasoning plantations that was worse than what was happening on the regular plantations? Well, one thing that they were doing on these plantations, especially in Jamaica, they were doing a process called buck breaking, where the white supremacist slave owner or the white supremacist overseer would literally rape black men in front of the whole black population in order to break his spirit, in order to break him down as a man, in order to show dominance against him, in order to show the rest of the black population that this is not your leader. I just made your leader submit to me sexually. And this happened a lot in Jamaica. This is why homosexuality is so looked down upon in Jamaican culture today.
And it was a way primarily of cutting down those who would rebel. In other words, it was a matter of power and control and domination. And they would call it buck busting, but it was really butt busting.
Slavery continued until 1865 for about 2 generations, right? So how do you reconcile that? You can no longer bring in Africans, but you still have the business of slavery. So they still needed Africans to do the work down south, especially after the cotton gin was invented. So you had the creation of breeding farms. 2 of the largest slave breeding farms in the United States were on the eastern shore of Maryland and right outside of Richmond, Virginia. They literally bred black people like cattle. They would have a strong black man have sex with a healthy black woman. That woman could be his mother, his sister, his aunt, his cousin. It didn't matter, because the end product was produce a child that I can sell, bodies that I can sell and ship down to Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina. It was a business.
We had breeding farms in the United States that would put one person from one plantation against another. We even had a system where if you were a breeder, male on one plantation, or a female on another plantation, or even on the same plantation, even if you were mother and son, they would mate you. And so I tell a lot of my patients and a lot of my friends, you gotta stop using the MF word, because that was a description of what actually happened when the paper bag would go over the head to put one breeder against another when they were related.